Candlestick Park, a stadium that has housed numerous championship teams, plays host for this afternoon's matchup between the Eagles and the 49ers.
The running back position today, manned by a couple of stars of the sport. What are you looking for here?
Yeah, it's kind of refreshing, isn't it, to do a game where it's all about the running backs. We have to talk about how good the quarterback is, and aren't they special? Well, these two running backs are special, and we see it each week how they play, and then also we see it how the offenses are designed. It is around the running backs.
They're setting up return.
Double, double, double.
The Eagles come to the line with a bunch set. He sends the halfback in motion. Dick standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Long ball to DeSean Jackson. What a catch. Touchdown.
How about that? Take that opening drive and go all the way down the field and score a touchdown. Well, you're talking about making you feel good. Everything you worked on in the week, it unfolded exactly like you thought it would here in today's game, and You're able to go down there and score on the opening drive.
The 49ers in kickoff return formation. Signals fair catch. And Crabtree is going to get set in the slot for this snap. Now first and 10. Frank Gore gets it here, and he's going to be tackled right around the 43.
That's a nice run that time by the offense, picking up those yards. And anytime you gain more than 3 yards on a running play in the National Football League, it is deemed successful.
Second down and 2. And the give to Frank Gore. Patrick Chung makes the hit, imposing their will early on the defense with a solid effort on the ground.
And we talk so much, don't we, about the passing game in the NFL, but it's still about who can out-hit the other one. And right now, the offense, they are winning that battle. Nice run.
Trying to establish the run, but there's nothing there here at the start.
Well, they didn't pick up many yards that time, no doubt about it, but that's a bad job by the running back. He picked the wrong side to run to. Nobody was blocked from the side he went to. After that long run, that running back deserves a break. Go over to the sideline, let a few guys pat you on the rear end and tell you how good you are, and then get a little oxygen and get back in the game. What a run.
And Crabtree's in the slot. Second and 11. Running to the right. It's often the difference maker in any game, and that is how you perform inside the red zone, and we're getting an early taste of that.
No doubt about it, Jim. You got to be creative when you get in the red zone. We'll see what the offense calls.
New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground. Trying to beat the play clock. First down and 10. Gore's got it again. He's brought to a halt.
Good job that time by the old line. How about that? Nice blocks, and they got a nice little run there inside the red zone.
Second down coming up. Gore. Wide to the left. Gains 12.
First down by the offense inside the red zone. Can the defense show them something different here and keep them from scoring a touchdown?
They're able to move the chains after that last run. Runs it in for the touchdown.
Well, this quarterback is not afraid to score on the goal line, that's for sure. Not afraid about taking a hit from one of those big, mean defensive players. He runs a quarterback sneak and gets a touchdown.
49ers setting up for the kickoff. He'll start his return. And the tackle's made. The offense will start their drive from about the 31. LeSean McCoy is in the backfield. Halfback sent in motion. First and 10. Long ball to DeSean Jackson. And it falls incomplete.
Well, for some reason, this quarterback likes to keep trying to go deep down the field against this cover two. That's not the spot you want to go. You want to look underneath or right down the middle.
The Eagles are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. Gets away from the pressure. And that gains a few. I know a lot of folks hold their breath when Vic decides to take off with it, but he can run the football. It's just a matter of how much punishment can he take.
Yeah, I like the fact that he will still run the football, Jim, but I like the fact even more if he'd learn to get down and not try to pick up those extra yards, because when you go for the extra yards, that's when you take the big hits.
LeSean McCoy takes the handoff. McCoy's a running back normally, but this time lined up as a receiver in the slot. Change of possession coming up as they fail to pick up the first down on fourth down. And Crabtree's lined up now as a slot receiver. Goes to the left, and here he goes. Touchdown, San Francisco.
Now you know why running backs get drafted high. Because these long running plays for touchdowns, that's what you want. That's what the NFL is about, making big plays. And when you get them in the running game, that's like double good.
The Eagles are prepared to return the kickoff. And he begins his return. And he's going to be brought down right around the 33-yard line. McCoy's in the slot, not in the backfield for this play. First and 10, running a little college-like option. And he is tackled down at the 38-yard line.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
They're running the option. Here's the pitch. And that's a big tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
That's just bad execution by the offense, bad decision by the quarterback. He pitches it out to the running back. Nowhere for the running back to go, and he lost a couple yards on the run.
Third and 5. Catch is made. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
How do you stop these receivers now? It's almost impossible with the rules of the game, tight coverage. That time they have double coverage on him. It doesn't matter. The throw comes, they go up, they make the catch. All you can do is raise your arm and go, well, we did our best. When you're an offensive lineman and you can line up and just run the football straight ahead and pick up those kind of yards, you are going to get into the head of the defense. You're basically saying, we're tougher than you are, and we're just going to come right at you.
First down here after the run. Michael Vick will take it from the gun. And that ball's nearly picked off, but he dropped it.
That's a nice route that time by the wide receiver, running the corner route, and the quarterback just throws it too far and misses it.
Play number six coming up on this drive. He'll fire it out to the left. That pass play picks up a first down.
This pass defense gives up more completions in the NFL than any other coverage by far. Yeah, they're stopping the deep passes down the field, four guys deep, but nobody's there to stop all the ones going across them.
Staying with the passing game on first down. Casey's there with the sure hands to pull in the rocket pass.
Perfect defense call that time. They allow the catch. The coach on the sidelines goes, well, what else do you want me to do? We had the guy double covered, and you still couldn't make the play.
The Eagles with a huge gainer right before the break, and now coming back to the line to start the second. First down following the long play. And the second quarter is underway into the end zone for the touchdown.
I would bet first and goal that the offense about 90% of the time is going to run the football. And what do they do here? They run it and they get it done. That is power football at its best.
The Eagles can tie it up with the point after. Extra point is good. The 49ers in kickoff return formation. Fair catch this time. And Crabtree's lined up in the slot. First and 10. They go to the right side. Frank Gore is in the backfield. Gore is going to take the handoff now.
The tackle was made, but the first down is picked up.
Nothing like seeing a complete offense. That's what we're watching here today, yes. We know they can throw it, but what they're showing us here, they can grind out some first downs running the football, too.
And Crabtree's a receiver in the slot. They hand it off to him again.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to, and also it opens up so many other things for your offense. This defense you're playing against, they're pretty good. So it's fourth down near midfield, punt the football.
It's a dime look for the defense on this play. Hauls it in for the first down.
I guess that's how we're going to be today, isn't it? We're just going to go for it on fourth down. That time they go for it and they get it. Good job.
Play number six coming up on this drive. First and ten. The quarterback will hand it off. They break through. Tackle him behind the line.
Now the play is there to be made, but the offensive player doesn't get it done. Bad job on first down.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. The formation here, shotgun. And it's incomplete. Just couldn't hold on to it after the hit.
That's interesting. As you watch the receiver trying to make that catch, he knew the defender was close, so he didn't put all of his heart into it. The defender made a nice hit and knocks the football out to the ground.
Loading up with extra defensive backs in the dime. Looking to the right side and throwing. Could have been intercepted.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
Offense lines up here. Throws to the right. The reception, easy, wide open.
Good job by the offense, another first down. The defense absolutely is getting tired. And when you get tired, you make mistakes.
That is play number 10 on this drive. First and 10. Into the open flat. Ball is caught. 49ers in the end zone.
Well, when your offense goes out there and scores a touchdown to put you ahead, it's got to give a big lift to the defense. They got to get excited and go out there and hold that lead.
Setting up for the kickoff. Always a threat, and he'll start his return now. Offense lines up here. First and 10. Going to take off with it. Looking for a receiver on the left side here. He's brought down.
Well, a couple things on that play. Of course, it's a nice job by the quarterback getting out of trouble and throwing the football on a run and getting the completion. But how about the defense? Quit being greedy. Stay in your rush lanes and don't let the quarterback get out.
Here's the give to LeSean McCoy.
What a good job by the defensive player there, just flushing the running back and driving him into the ground.
Offense lines up here. Second and six. McCoy is going to secure the football on the toss. We've hit the two-minute warning here in the first half.
What that run does, it just puts the offense in a good situation. So a good, positive run.
Third down following the run. Vic's going to keep the football on the quarterback sneak.
Defenses are so aggressive in these situations now. A lot of coaches don't want to turn around and hand the ball off to somebody that's 6 or 7 yards deep. Use your quarterback, run that quarterback sneak, and a good job picking up the first down.
Second down coming up.
Play action. Going across the middle. No one was open.
As much as these guys practice during the offseason, training camp, during the week, you think receivers and quarterbacks would always be on the same page. That time they were not, and it's another incomplete pass.
Play number six coming up on this drive. Third down and eight. Running it like it's an option play.
A tackle that had to be made, and that'll set up fourth down. Wide receivers are bunched up.
Back in shotgun formation.
The throw to the left.
So that's not going to get it done here. And the offense is going to turn it over on downs.
Good job by the linebacker. Just watching the quarterback, reading his eyes. He made the move at the right time, and he knocked the pass down.
The defense comes out in the nickel.
First and 10. Frank Gore gets it here. He stacked up at that point.
Good job by the defensive player squaring up that running back and just putting his big butt right into the ground.
Michael James is in the backfield. Second and eight. He'll fire it out to the left. That's a gain of eight. The 49ers signal for the timeout. And that's the first one they've used. Defense here trying to avoid the deep pass. Throwing now to his left. The 49ers now move the chains.
Zone defense doesn't work in the NFL like it used to. Good job by the quarterback reading that zone and finding the open guy.
First down here after the completion. Trying to work that left side. That catch will extend the drive.
What a nice catch by the receiver to get past the yard markers. Makes the catch and gets a first down.
Reception gave them the first down. He's looking to go down the field here. A takeaway. Tackles made. The 49ers are going to use one of the two timeouts they have remaining. Up, up.
ready for intermission. First, one more play.
McCoy slashing to the right side. He'll be taken down about 3 yards short of the first.
So that's going to do it for the first half. 49ers are up in this one.
We're back here now in this one, where the 49ers are leading by 7.
Let's go back to the sidelines. Danielle Bellini has the latest.
I had a moment to speak with Coach Kelly during halftime. It's an uphill battle for his team guys as they head into the second half. But he says it's not the time to get frustrated. There's no reason to try and be a hero. Just follow the game plan and things will work themselves out. I'll send it back up to you guys.
Danielle, thank you very much. Now we'll go to the field. They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. Second half gets rolling now as he takes the snap.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
The defense comes out of the dime. Second and 12. Looks to his left. No one in sight. Has the grab. Touchdown, 49ers.
What a terrible job by the defense. That time, nobody even covers the receiver. He is wide open down the field, and, hey, nice job by the quarterback going through his progression. He finds the open guy and gets a touchdown pass.
The 49ers lined up now for the point after. The point after try is in the books. Eagles are prepared to return the kickoff. Signaling for fair catch. First down. The Eagles get a first down.
Well, when your team is behind, what do? Just come out there and get a first down. That's a nice job by the offense.
McCoy's in the backfield. Single back set. Hand off to the back. Trying to find an opening to the right. And Navarro Bowman brings him down.
When you have a defense that's not playing good techniques, they're selling out, overplaying plays. Well, you run the counter runs to counteract what they're doing on the defensive side.
The ball is out. They recover their own fumble.
One thing coaches hate when their offense is on the field is fumbling the football, because a lot of times it's just bad fundamentals. But they're lucky this time. They have the fumble. They're able to get on top of it.
Reaches in, and that pass is incomplete.
Hey, good job that time by the safety. He watched the quarterback, got in position, and knocked that football down.
Second down following that incompletion.
The ball's deflected, incomplete.
Oh, the safety has so much talent. He's got the speed. He's got smarts. Got in great position and just swatted that football away.
Jackson's going to get set in the slot for this snap.
Third and 10.
He's looking to the right here on this throw. The tackle's going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker.
Well, when you get a couple first downs, it just gives you such great confidence. It makes everybody relax. And I always say this, if you're a relaxed athlete, that's when you play your best.
He makes the catch, and he'll step out of bounds.
Good job by the receiver, running into that defense, through the zone, finding the open space, and making a nice catch.
LeSean McCoy is in the backfield.
A second down and one.
He'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
Well, it's about deceiving the defense, isn't it? That's how you get a lot done in the NFL. And when you can run and pass, you can deceive them in a lot of ways. Nice job by the offense, running that football, picking up another first down and moving the chains.
Well, anytime you're in the red zone, you want to punch it in and get that touchdown. If they do that, look, they're still going to be behind, but it gives them confidence moving forward.
Second down and six, right back to him one more time.
That time I got to blame the running back. He made a bad read. His vision was terrible. He makes the wrong decision, and it cost his team yards lost.
LeSean McCoy takes the handoff.
Good job by the offense getting in the red zone. Now you're down some points. You got to find a way to score a touchdown.
Receiver on the right. They pounce on him there.
Good play call that time by the offensive coordinator. Down inside, when you're inside that 20-yard line or the red zone, find ways to complete the pass. They did that time.
First and goal. McCoy's got it on the handoff.
It's a nice drive by the offense, Jim. They're down. They're driving down the field. Let's see if they can put 7 points on the board.
Play after play after play here on this drive. Second and goal from the six. Catch is made. Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow. But the good news is, I think he's going to be okay. And once he gets a little situated there, I think he'll be back in the game.
The offense heads to the line for the 14th play of this drive. Sticks to touchdown. And this game just got a whole lot more interesting.
Well, that's a good touchdown by the offense there. And, you know, and what it's done, it's gotten this game closer. Gives them confidence, and confidence is a dangerous thing. We'll see if they can keep moving forward after this.
Brown's taking the handoff to the right side, and so they convert it here on the two-point try. He's put the ball on the tee, and he's about to kick off. Signals right away, fair catch. Bolden's in the slot. Colin Kaepernick from the shotgun. He's wide open for the grab. 49ers in for the score.
You got to take advantage of situations like this. Not often in the NFL do you get somebody this wide open. Good job by the receiver. Nice job by the quarterback seeing him. And what do you get? An easy touchdown pass.
49ers setting up for the kickoff.
He's got a chance to return this one.
Taken down at about the 33, maybe the 34-yard line.
And it's the base 24.
Brown's lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. The running back goes in motion. First and 10. Working that left side. Intercepted.
Linebackers nowadays are so talented. They can just do everything. They're strong enough to stop the run. But how about this interception? Good job. Good reading of the quarterback and a nice catch.
Bolden's lined up now as a slot receiver. First and 10. LaMichael James to the right. Got the first, and he's got some space.
What a job that time by the offensive line. That hole was so big, you could have drove a car through it. The running back hit it full speed, and that allowed him to get down the field and get that long run.
New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground. Leading on that running attack again here on first down.
And this defense, they are tough. When you run that football, they got some men up front. And that time they stopped that run just for a short gain.
Bolden's lined up in the slot. Kaepernick from the gun. He's scrambling now, sliding to get away from the hit.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
And Crabtree's a receiver in the slot. Third and one. Trying the right side. Takes it the distance for the touchdown.
Well, you got a lead. Now you're able to go out there and drive down the field and score a touchdown. This changes how the other team is going to manage the game from here on out.
49ers setting up for the kickoff. They're setting up the return. And he's going to be brought down right around the 33-yard line. We'll have one more play before the quarter expires. Picks up four.
That was a running play that time by the offense. It picked up some good yards. Nothing like it. Show the defense you're willing to get in there and slug it out and get some tough running yards.
Base 24.
Bryce Brown is in the backfield. The final quarter begins with this snap. Shakes off the tackle. Ball is out. Recovery by the offense.
There's always a rule on the offensive side when the football is fumbled. Little guys pick it up, fat guys fall on it. Don't try to pick it up if you're one of the fat guys. That time they get it done and recover their own fumble.
They go counter. That'll put them in what we call plus territory.
That's an excellent job. Just getting enough yardage to get the first down, move those chains, and keep this offense going.
Cooper's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Running to the left side. He's into the open. In on the stop.
Anytime you get in the red zone, you want to punch it in there and get 7 points. They're being dominated today. They're down more than seven. But don't worry about it. Score here and just keep playing.
First and 10. Right side. Pitches it back. He steps out.
Closer defense gets to the end zone. Their backs are against it. The tougher they get. But that time, the offense still able to pick up a few yards on an inside run.
Coming up, second down. Eyeing that left side. Touchdown. Man, they cut into that lead.
Well, it's a nice touchdown drive by the offense. They're still behind, but I got to say this to the defense. You're just giving up. You're letting them march down there and letting them get back in the game. Toughen up and get it done.
Well, this works out about 40% of the time if you look back on history, and they'll go for that two-point conversion. And they will not convert here on the two-point conversion. Good stand by the defense. They're lining up for the onside kick. They want to get the ball back. The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it. And Crabtree's in the slot. Now first and 10. Good piece of tackling.
Safeties now in the NFL have to cover like a corner, and they got to tackle like a linebacker. And that time the safety came up, and he tackled like a linebacker and stopped that outside run.
Second down here. And the give to Frank Gore. Left side. Bolden's lined up now as a slot receiver. Third and 9. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
What a good job by the defensive player there, just flushing the running back and driving him into the ground.
The 49ers in field goal formation.
As a defense, the offense has great field position. You got to give them something different. The defense did. They stopped them, and they gave up the field goal.
He's a dangerous returner, and he'll have a chance to show you right here. First down here, challenging the defenders to the right side.
When you can't hit the quarterback or put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time and throws it down the field for another completion.
Bryce Brown is in the backfield, looking to the right side and throwing. The pass is intercepted. That'll stop the play right there.
Most NFL linebackers, they're borderline good enough to be a running back, and they got the hands of defensive backs. Here's a good case. What a fine catch on the interception by the linebacker.
Now on first down.
In trouble now.
And he's brought down by Connor Barwin.
Gain of two on the play.
Defense now signaling for a timeout.
Last play before the two-minute warning.
Second and eight. Throws to the right. He has the grab. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
Two-minute warning.
First down on the way. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Tackle down right around the 48.
Good job by the quarterback that time. He doesn't panic. He reads that it's a zone, and you have to wait for the receivers to get in between the defenders. Nice throw and catch.
Launching it deep. But it's incomplete.
Deep passes in the NFL, they always serve a purpose. You're not always going to get the completion, but at least it gets the defense thinking that you will try some long throws down the field.
Ohio!
Frank Gore is in the backfield. Running away from the pressure.
Well, I guess you can see why the defense is not having a spy on this quarterback, because even when he breaks the pocket on third and short, still not able to get the first down.
Kaepernick's got it in the gun. That catch, good for a first down.
Got to have a lot of courage to call these type of plays, don't you, Jim? And at that time, even though this team is winning, the coach decides to go for it on fourth down. Good play call, and they make it work.
The 49ers now move the chains.
That's a nice job by the offense there. Get the first down. Keep those chains moving. Give yourself three more opportunities.
This will be the eighth play of this drive. He'll fire it out to the left. Airtight coverage. Incomplete.
This is frustrating for a coach. You call a play, you get the receiver down the field on a corner route, and your quarterback cannot put it on the target.
Second down after the incompletion. Colin Kaepernick from the shotgun.
Loads it up, going deep.
Incompletion there, just not quite able to get the feet down.
I'd like to see this team throw the football down the field a little more often. That time it doesn't result in a completion, but just keep trying.
What a drive this has been. Third and 10. He's going deep.
There's a sideline pass. Incomplete. It's ruled.
And this will be from 47 yards, the field goal attempt.
The kick is good.
And offense drives the ball. They always want to get something out of it, get some points. This time, the field goal kicker gets it done. He gives him three.
DeSean Jackson with a chance here on the kickoff. Spins away from the tackle. In the backfield. First down and 10. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Got a hand on it, and it's incomplete.
Oh, nice job. That cornerback, he was watching the quarterback. He's all over the receiver. So it was easy for him to knock the throw down.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. Up the middle. He's going to be tackled right around the 42-yard line.
It's a mindset. It's a culture. That's what you got to create when you talk about running the football. And when you get it going the right way, you can grind a defense up. Another first down for this offense running the football.
First and 10. Long ball to DeSean Jackson.
Good job by the defense. They are all over the field by the quarterback. They almost pick it off in the end zone. So that's a big opportunity missed when you drop a pass like that.
Browns shifted from running back to a receiver in the slot. Second and 10. They up the middle.
Coach going to hear about this when the game is over. Running the football in a situation like this, late in the game, you're down multiple scores. You got to take some chances. You got to throw it, and you got to throw it down the field.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Third and 7. With two hands, he has it. Blindly spins away from the hit. The 49ers call a timeout and are left now with only one. Alex Henry for the field goal try. No, it's not. It's a fake. Challenging the defenders to the right side.
Oh, bad decision on time by the quarterback. He tries to force the football into the end zone, and it almost gets picked off by the defense.